Now imagine this situation. Right now it might not seem really appetizing or practical. You are getting off from work. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop me whenever you get off at work, right? You're getting off from work, you're hungry because you missed the last meal because there was so much to do. And you're going back home. What's the only thing on your mind? Cursing your manager, absolutely. Thank you for the honesty. Highly appreciate that honesty. But apart from cursing your manager, you have a problem at hand. What is that problem at hand? Traffic, thank you. That's very Bangalorean of you to say that, yes. You have hunger on your mind, right? What do you do? What do you plan on doing? Eat, right? Swiggy, Zomato, whatever brands you may want to take. You want to get it done with as soon as possible. You really don't feel like going and sitting somewhere and eating. You really don't feel like going and picking up something from somewhere. And if possible, you might as well would prefer someone else do the ordering for you. Yes or no? Right? If you could have a voice command and say, can you order chicken biryani for me, please? And take care of everything along with that. Wouldn't you like that? Yes or no? I mean, barring the chicken biryani aspect, you know, any other food for that matter. In principle, wouldn't you prefer that? Wouldn't you prefer that? Yes, perfect. So we have someone who is working towards enabling that levels of laziness that we all have become accustomed to in this point. We have Ankit here with us. Ankit is the founder and CEO of DataWiz. He's a seasoned IT professional with over 11 years of experience working on various domains. A technology business leader experienced in various domains like telecom, cybersecurity, travel, and e-commerce. We were just talking about the Otter Trotter. Right? So we were talking about Otter Trotter. Currently, you're running DataWiz with a vision to participate in the creation and evolution of voice mediums and enable people to use voice as a primary medium to interact with technology for any means.
So as Ramesh mentioned, right, laziness, or I'll put it in other words, comfort. Okay. What voice brings? Okay, it brings comfort. Okay, two people sitting next to each other, working on something. Okay, what we do, we are stuck in a problem. We are going to do a Slack or a Skype, right? We're just going to talk to that guy or girl. Correct? Okay, fine. So that's what I want to bring, as in, bring comfort to all the individual users of voice, so that, you name it. The use cases are unlimited, starting from food to ordering stuff from online, right? Now, we've been very much vigilant when it comes to offers, right? So what if those offers comes inbuilt with Alexa? Wouldn't that be exciting? Okay, so I would want you to stay with me. I know it's going to be difficult. Ramesh introduced me. I'm a founder and CEO of DataWiz. We've been working specifically with enterprises to bring them onto voice-enabled interface, so that we don't just keep using Alexa to play music or to, get the weather information or get the traffic information for us. Okay, that's in nutshell, that's what we do. So agenda, or what I would want to convey today, is three major things. Okay, what? What as in, what is voice commerce? Okay, second, why? Why as a brand I should choose voice commerce to be something, to watch out for, and how? So we've built a product which has multiple stuff, but one of the things that I'm going to talk about today is WooCommerce. WooCommerce is an e-commerce engine, which I think probably a lot of you guys would know. Okay. So the how part, we are going to try out few stuff. I don't have much time today, but we are going to do a short stuff to understand that how can you connect your WooCommerce engine into Alexa, so that you can bring whatever products which are there in WooCommerce engine to the Alexa platform itself. Okay, everybody's with me? Just say, okay, good, fine. So let's understand first what. One of my favorite slides. Okay, I'm gonna stay back a bit. So I have a habit of walking, so. Okay, so understand this slide very, like one of my favorite slides. 20 years, 2 decades, 5 waves of digital disruptions that we have seen. Okay, I think everybody must be following me here. Web, everybody knows, right? Earlier we used to, you know, go out to shops to, you know, check out clothes and order different stuff, right? Then came in web interfaces where we started, you know, ordering by going through websites and checking different stuff, right? Then came in search, Google, Yahoo, Amazon, you know, talking about searching your favorite stuff online, right? I'm looking for a white shirt. I'm looking for an Avengers Endgame Edition t-shirt, something like that, right? It's a very, you know, inherent to us to search something nowadays. It's very easy, right? Okay, search. Then let's talk about social. Then what happened? We started, you know, getting influenced by social platforms. Okay, so we have started seeing, you know, somebody wearing something and then thinking that, okay, fine, where do I find the same clothes, right? So social, making it shareable. You know, earlier we don't even had phones, right, to capture the photo, what am I looking at. Now what happens is, first thing that you go for a shopping into a trial room, what do? Take a nice selfie, right? Guys with me or not? I'm worried. Okay, fine. So what we do is, we take a nice selfie. What we do with that? Let's share it. You know, let's keep it, our WhatsApp story is running, Instagram story is running. So we've been to a stage where we are using social channels to make the content shareable. Okay. Then came in the mobile wave. Okay, the one thing that we are so used to this day, Zomato and Swiggy, right? Earlier, we used to call restaurants, you know, why don't you send me a chicken biryani or a masala dosa or something like that. Now, what we do is, you know, let's see where the offers are. What is the best food that I can get with a very good price, right? So, we've been going to mobile-centric world now. Wherein what happens is, people started moving from web to mobile apps, okay? We've seen another trend into this nowadays. Okay, that is the last segment that I'm going to talk about, is voice. Okay, you have seen a lot of other stuff, Hanuman Chalisa to, you know, Hindi stories to Bollywood Hangama, the skill that we have. It's more on the content side. Okay, but what about bringing skills which helps you to get things done? Get things done as in, you know, I'm a coffee lover. Okay, I love drinking coffee. Now, wouldn't that be good that Alexa tells me every month that, hey, your coffee refill is about to over, why don't you refill it? Okay, so those are the options that we want to bring as an enterprise into this voice-enabled medium, so that we bring comfort to the users. The way we are comfortable in using mobile phones these days, we could bring the same comfort into using voice-enabled mediums. It could be anything, right? And it could be any medium as in. Okay, as long as you can talk to the brand that you love, okay, the possibilities are endless. It could be a coffee brand, it could be a restaurant nearby, it could be a grocer next to your, you know, place where you're staying in, right? Wouldn't that be great? Yes or no? Okay, I think everybody's still awake, everybody's still with me. Let's understand, what is voice commerce? So, in nutshell, it's an hands-free experience. What I want to do is, I'm chilling in my home, you know, my coffee is over. What do I do? It's a lazy Sunday afternoon or Sunday evening, you know, I'm chilling at my place and I want to order, I see that my coffee is done, what should I do? I'll get up, pick up my phone, search an app, or go to a website, then, you know, refill all the information, then place an order, then do the payment. This is the whole process, correct? Versus, hey Alexa, why don't you refill a coffee for me? And your order goes through. That's the comfort that voice commerce brings into this industry. Okay, everybody's with me? Okay, so this is all about what? Okay, what is voice commerce? What do we mean by, you know, bringing voice commerce at a stage where we are? Okay, and let's talk about why. So understand one thing. We've understood what is voice commerce. Let's understand why this is the right time to get into a voice-enabled platform as a brand to utilize this channel as a good sales and marketing channel for us. Okay, so that's what we are going to answer in why. Let's understand few stats. Okay, what do consumers like when it comes to voice? One of the best thing that you could do is hands-free shopping. Okay, yes, if you think of things that needs a visual aspect, then yes, you would need to go to a mobile app or, you know, a web app or something. But it could be a food, it could be your daily groceries, it could be your coffee, right? These are the stuff which you don't need to go and, you know, choose, pick and choose, right? You don't need to have a visual element in. Okay, that's where, you know, consumers like using voice commerce. You know, it could be, for example, it could be pharmacy, right? You know which medicine usually you take, why don't you order it directly? Okay, or in nutshell, what we do is we basically, you know, bouquet the things directly in the brands itself. So what happens is I know what particular user is ordering every month or every week, one after another. So I know what bouquet of things I need to help him to refill. Okay, so as a brand, I can push that information over this medium and get the refills done. For brands, it's a reordering done at ease, and for users, for consumers, it's convenience. Okay, so what do, you know, consumers like? It's a hands-free. I can do other things while ordering, right? I'm chopping few vegetables, and I remember that I needed to order a cake. You can go to Alexa right now and, you know, order a cake using various skills. Okay, where do we improve? What are the things that people don't like? Okay, one of the major things is the invisibility factor. Okay, what happens is when you are using a mobile app or a web app, you know what interactions you are doing, right? Okay, but when it comes to voice, what happens is everything is invisible. When you say something, okay, you basically have a question in mind that, okay, fine, what did Alexa understood? What did that went into my cart, and what's going to show up at my door? Okay, so one of the things that needs to be improved is the reliability factor. Okay, reliability factor would come in, the more people use, the more comfort or more knowledgeable Alexa would get. Okay, so yeah, see, the third thing, there's no screen. Okay, there are things which you cannot order without seeing. For example, clothes. I would want to see which color it is. I would want to see which size it is. I would want to see how does that thing look when, you know, somebody wears it, as in model photos and all that stuff, right? So that's where, you know, we see voice commerce needs to improve in general. Let's understand types of shoppers. Okay, there are various categories when it comes to types of shoppers. If you see, 31% of the audience, okay, ordered something new. Why? Okay, so do you remember a time when Zomato just launched in Bangalore and other cities? Okay, what we did is, they had simply offer, right? If you install an app, the first few orders, first three orders to your favorite restaurant would get humongous discount. Okay, so that helped you to order something new on a new platform. That's trust building. That's how we get people onto a new platform. So right now the trends when it comes to voice commerce is that, you know, it does good when you pitch something new to the users and ask them to use voice enabled interfaces to get the ordering done. Okay, 20% of those people said, you know, I've done both. So if your skill is good, okay, you'll see the first traction and then reordering. For example, coffees. Okay, we've seen a lot of startups coming in to Indian space, Indian market, as in coffee brands. Now, coffee catalogs are very limited, right? And you as a user would know always what kind of a coffee you like. Do you like a dark roast coffee or a light roast coffee? Do you want a vanilla flavor or a butterscotch? That is something which is very personalized, right? So I don't need to go through a bouquet of menus and searches to order something. These are kind of a placements which does good when it comes to voice commerce. Okay,
23% says, you know, yeah, I reordered a previous purchase. That is something which is very, very required. Okay, so as a brand, if you're selecting somebody to come onto a voice-enabled platform, reordering efficiency needs to be pre-built. As in, you know, you should know what users are ordering, and you need to come up with a approach in which you can allow users to reorder something. You know, Domino's. Domino's is a prominent skill in US market for reordering pizza. In India, we are using it less, but think of it this way. The first thing that Domino's skill would ask you is, do you want to reorder your last order? Okay. What happens in that case is, it helps me to decide directly. Okay, otherwise what will happen is, I'll have to think, you know, what do I need to order, what are the coupons going on, what are the different stuff going on, versus you stop user right away saying that, you know, fine, do you want to reorder the same thing which you did last time? That brings comfort. So reordering should be one of the priorities when it comes to voice commerce and bringing brands onto voice enabled interfaces. What that will do is, it will bring convenience to your users, and your reordering, your sales would go up in that way. Okay, now one of the good stuff. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, that reliability or invisibility is one of the factors which is affecting voice commerce right now. But let's understand what are the, you know, proportion of the order size when somebody orders through any voice enabled interfaces. Okay, so if you see, 37% people order something in between $20 to $50. Okay, which is a good amount for a voice enabled interface. Okay, you could think of a lot of different stuff. It could be groceries, it could be coffees, it could be medicines, it could be electronics. Okay, everybody would know, what kind of a charger do I need, right? I can simply go into an Alexa and say that, you know, find me a charger for type USB type C. It's easy, right? So the order sizes between $20 to $50, it's gonna be a working model for voice commerce. If you start selling jewelries on voice commerce, it's not gonna work, right? Everybody's with me? Okay, good to hear that. I need to keep reminding you, the session is on, the food is off. Okay, fine. So you see the order sizes, right? It's between $20 to $50 maximum. There are certain stuff in which people have ordered more than $200 items as well. But what happens is, it could be a bouquet of things. For an example, Valentine's Day is coming, right? I know I need to give something to someone. Now what do? If that brand gives me a selection that, you know, why don't you order our Valentine's special? I don't need to go and search their whole bouquet of things that they have. I can simply go and say, okay, fine, order me a Valentine's special. And we are done. I'm shorted. I don't have to worry about, you know, taking care of my Valentine's gift. Okay. So let's understand next thing, and this is a good comparison between an online shopping and voice shopping. And like you'll see the trends, even the appearance doesn't seem to be good fitment for voice category. Okay, it's been doing good, and I'll tell you how and when. But if you see apparel, most of the people buy apparels online these days, 60% of them. Okay, but if you see the trend, 21% of them are okay buying stuff on voice enabled interfaces as well. How? Why? Socks, handkerchiefs, accessories, perfumes, you name it, right? These are the stuff where you don't need much options. Correct? Okay. Let's talk about everyday household items. Maximum selling items when it comes to, for example, Amazon Pantry. I think, how many of you used Amazon Pantry? Raise your hand. Wow, a lot of good users. Fine. So what happens is, Amazon Pantry, what if, you know, it gives you native notification that your month is over. Do you want me to refill your pantry? Yes and no, and you know, your pantry gets refilled. So daily household stuffs are some of the highest selling entities on voice commerce. Coffees could be part of it. Medicines could be part of it. Okay. Your, you know, if you're ordering your beauty products, you know, girls are very particular. Not being gender biased here, but girls are particular about the brands that they want to use when it comes to beauty products, right? So what if I bring them online? Or Nykaa, right? Nykaa is one of the famous brands. You know what you need to order, correct? So those are the stuff are good fitment for voice enabled industries. appliances, groceries, games, travel, consumer electronics. These are the stuff which are doing good when it comes to voice commerce. Everybody's with me? Yeah, okay, good to hear that. So let's understand few good stuff. Now, when it comes to Amazon Alexa, okay, we need to understand how do we bring visibility to the users. For an example, somebody going and talking to Alexa, hey Alexa, buy me a cake. Now, there could be 100 different skills, 100 different brands on Alexa skill store which sells cake. Now, how does Alexa pick and choose? How do you stand out your brands on Alexa skill store? Okay. These are the, some of the stuff that I'm going to talk about. Okay, now, a lot of this is focused with US store because in-skill purchase is something which is not available in India yet. But voice commerce is going to go on the same principles as this for Indian market as well. So, Wikipedia is a key store for brand information. Okay, for an example, somebody is looking for cake. You know, if you do Google, what does it do? If you don't find it, it's going to give you a search results. Right? Yelp for customer reviews and everything. Okay. And Amazon Choice pays dividends on voice. So what happens is I brought my brand on voice right now. Okay. They are simply selling, for example, coffee. Okay. Right now there are no other brands who are selling coffees on the platform. What happens is your indexing gets stronger. Whenever somebody says, hey Alexa, find me a coffee or order me a coffee. Okay. If your brand is associated with a coffee as a tagline, says, you know, there are tags and information that you need to fill up, right? When you submit a skill to skill store, there are insulin information that you need to fill up. Okay. So those are the stuff which is going to let your brand discoverable on Alexa skill store. This is one of the amazing and prominent aspect when it comes to voice commerce, because whatever products that you want to sell on voice-enabled mediums, you need to ensure that, you know, you have visibility of your product. The same way you do for web and mobile app, right? You do SEOs, you do SMOs to make your product stand out on web and mobile, right? When you do a search of, for example, you know, Apple iPhone 6, what happens is the Google shows up the list of products directly from Amazon, Flipkart, and all the e-commerce providers that we have. Similarly, Alexa can do the same. What it can tell you is basically, you know, I'm looking for something and there are multiple skills. It can ask you that I find few options for you. Can you pick any from it? Okay. So that's how visibility comes for your brand. The more content that you have, the more reliable it will get to make your, you know, Alexa to stand out. Alexa skill to stand out. Yeah. Fourth thing, can fulfillment request. Okay. Okay, this is something which is not yet active in India. In US also, this is something which is in beta stage. But if you are an Alexa developer, this is something that you should try on. Okay, can fulfillment intent request is something that would help you to bring discoverably on the Alexa skill store. So friends, somebody's asked for, you know, buy me a cake. So that cake is a product that user wants to search. If your can fulfillment intent content which talks about, you know, I'm looking for a cake, or I'm selling a cake, or I'm a cake, I'm a baker, right? These are the related content to somebody searching for a cake. If you have this can fulfillment intent available, you will be able to use that and make your app stand up on the indexing when it comes to Alexa skill search. Okay, last but not least, keep an eye on Alexa conversation. This is one of the good topic. And there are blogs available on Alexa's developer platforms as well. Alexa conversation is going to be next thing. Yeah, this is something which is still in not available in India and it's in beta stage. But what happens is it brings a whole conversation with an associated skill. So what happens is I'm looking for a cab and I'm looking for a taxi. This is the conversation that you're making with Alexa skill. Okay, I'm looking to buy a coffee. So this is conversation that I'm doing with the Alexa. Now, if you have the same Alexa conversation content available on your skills, okay, what happens is Alexa would be able to relate your skill with the user's request. That would give more information, more outreach for your skills, and in turn, you will be able to place, you will be able to get orders from your users for your brand. I'll go a bit quicker because we have last 5 minutes. So I'll have. So these are the four segments that I see. How do you get your skills presentable in form of voice form? Onboard, monitor, fulfill, loyalty. Onboarding. So how do you onboard a user? Accept new subscription. So it could be anything, right? It could be a subscription-based model. It could be selling some products on Alexa skills. So you could accept new subscription. You could let the users check availability of subscription packages, cost of different products, and whatnot. Okay. And let user check for pickup points nearby. For an example, you are a grocery store, right? You want to see that, okay, I want to get my orders ready when I go and pick up those stuff. You could do that using. Okay. Monitor. So one of the cool aspects of having something on Alexa platform is you will be able to monitor what users are using. For. You know which bouquet of things that you want to offer to the users in a way that you get reorders. So you let users monitor their, okay, other thing is you let the users order their monitor their orders. Where is my orders, whether it is ready or not, monitor their usage or track their subscription. For example, I'm a coffee subscription business. Okay, I have a package of 5 coffees a month or something like that. How many of it I've ordered already, how many left, what are my payment dates, whatnot, right? So you can allow users to monitor their usage, their orders, their status and everything using Alexa. Fulfill. So now this is where your brand stands out. So how much fulfillment you offer to your users, how many products they can buy, okay, how many let users do the payment for their service. Then you can use the native payments that you already have, right? Amazon Pay, PayU, whatever you are using. At the end of the day, you can send a notification in form of emails to get things. Okay. One of the cool aspects of bringing brands to voice-enabled business is loyalty. Okay. So everybody knows, right? And I'm paying, I'm in Zomato, premium customer. Okay. I'm getting certain points. You know, there were Zomato points that they enabled. Okay. So you could do the same thing on Alexa platform as well. Okay. Whenever somebody orders from Alexa or from voice-enabled platform, you give them certain rewards to get them onto a platform where they get habituated using it and they keep on reordering the same stuff using the platform. Basically, it makes kind of a billing cycle where where user is going to reorder the same stuff again. It means a recurring business to the user. Okay, I'll be going very quick with this, but WooCommerce. It's a very well-known e-commerce platform. So how do you connect a simple WooCommerce store of your customer? Get that engaged skill. Ideally, what you could do is basically, you create an Alexa skill, create an API key on the e-commerce. Connect me later on to understand because we are out of time. But what happens is on WooCommerce, you can create API key, connect a lot of stuff form of API. So Alexa, when somebody invokes that skill, sends an API request to the platform. It basically talks about product searches, product details, orders, reorders, coupons, and everything. Okay. What are different things that you could try? You could display offers. You could display different product categories. Describe product variation. You could confirm the quantity. You could allow users to play. This is an ideal flow, ideal voice user interface design that you should do when it comes to voice commerce. Okay, so this is last thing. So these are some of the API calls. I'm going to publish my deck as well, so you could go through them. So these are the stuff that we have tried. Okay, so these are the native APIs which is available in WooCommerce engine. Connect that with an API gateway. What happens is you would be able to search, categorize, order and do the payments as well. And then once order is done, you can push that information to user in form of notifications and everything. Okay. So that's me. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that insight into voice commerce. I'm pretty sure it did not help the cause that he kept talking about food as most of the examples, right? Although this is probably the best time you can have it. Cannot have it right before lunch. And as someone who is constantly lazy or, you know, in Ankit's words, seeking comforts, I'm really looking forward to voice commerce becoming more and more accepted and widespread. To give a small token of appreciation, I'd like to call upon stage Ilan